Hey guys, Cam McCall here. By now, you've probably watched the walkthrough to hear why I'm so stoked on this new slash. If you haven't, check that out first. We're here right now to go a little deeper into this high pivot suspension design and talk about what makes slash the best pedaling high pivot out there. We're going to talk about a few concepts today, but the first one is axle path. Just like it sounds, we're talking about the path your rear axle takes when your suspension compresses. Most bikes with main pivots closer to the bottom bracket have a mostly vertical axle path. Think of the axle as a point on the circumference of a circle, and the main pivot as the center. With a lower pivot, the axle starts its trajectory higher up on the circle, so it moves along the vertical part of the circumference. When we move that main pivot higher, that means that now the axle starts its trajectory lower on the circumference, so it moves along the part of the circle that's going backward in relation to the rest of the bike, resulting in a rearward axle path. On the trails, that feels like a quicker reaction to bumps with more momentum and less hang-up on square-edged hits. Think about the direction of force coming from bumps. Bumps push back on the wheel. So when you have a rearward axle path, that means the wheel moves in the same direction as the force from the bumps. In other words, the rear wheel moves out of the way of the bumps easier and faster than a rear wheel with a more vertical axle path. So you're probably thinking, well, that sounds great, Cam, but there's gotta be a catch. Well, there is a catch. A rearward axle path also means that the distance between the cogs and the chainring grows, which pulls backward on the chain. That's called chain growth. Why is chain growth bad? Think about what happens if you pull backwards on your chain. Your pedals move backwards too. That's called pedal kickback, and it makes for a harsh ride that beats up your legs as you're standing up on those pedals. That chain tension also counteracts the suspension, so it can't work as freely as it should. But there is a solution. Hooray! While the rearward axle path increases the distance between the axle and the chainring, it doesn't increase the distance between the axle and that high main pivot. So by routing the chain around this idler pulley, we get rid of that chain growth effect. That takes care of the top part of the chain, but the bottom section of the chain also grows when the suspension compresses. A lot of bikes just let the rear derailleur cage take up that extra tension, but that can really affect your shifting performance. So, we also have this lower idler pulley that mitigates lower chain growth and frees up the derailleur to do its job. And since it takes that tension off the chain, that also means the suspension can work better, since it's not fighting against the tension from the derailleur's clutch. So what does this all mean to you, my fellow mountain biker? It means you get an instant confidence upgrade on the sketchiest trails. Since that back wheel moves with the hits, you don't feel them as much, and you maintain way more momentum. The rougher it gets, the more this bike shines. You get insane traction and control that lets you point and shoot down boulder-strewn minefields without getting pinballed around. Now, one of the most common complaints about high pivot bikes is that they don't pedal well, but this is not your standard high pivot bike. We know that on a trail bike like this, you're just trying to get to that next descent, but that doesn't mean the climb has to be miserable. Trek's engineers spent tons of time optimizing the anti-squat curve on this bike, so it pedals way better than other high pivots, and even better than a lot of conventional trail bikes. Anti-squat is how much your suspension resists compression from the forces that come from the rider, like pedaling and shifting your weight around. The amount of anti-squat a bike has is mostly determined by where the main pivot is placed, but the idler size and position affects it too. Trek's engineers went through tons of testing and iterations to get all those variables just right for how they wanted this bike to pedal. Compared to our other high pivot bike, the downhill session, the main pivot is placed further forward, while the idler is placed slightly behind and under the main pivot, rather than concentric to it. The result is that slash has a super efficient and consistent feeling anti-squat curve with values from 100 to 105%. That's about the same anti-squat as Top Fuel, which gets rave reviews for its pedaling efficiency. You're probably wondering why we don't design such high anti-squat into all of our trail bikes. Well, that's because on longer travel bikes, high anti-squat causes pedal kickback. But just like we learned earlier, we can dodge the effects of that with the idler pulley, which is another thing that makes this bike pedal better than other high pivot bikes. The pulley itself is bigger than other idlers. The bigger the pulley, the less the chain has to bend to go around it, and less bending is more efficient. Combined with the super high amount of anti-squat in this design, this layout makes Slash more efficient than most long travel bikes. So you can save your legs for smashing that next descent.